وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى today I want to speak about قوله تعالى ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا حملت أمه كرها ووضعته كرها وحمله وفصاله 30 شهرا حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة قال رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين أولئك الذين نتقبل عنهم أحسن ما عملوا ونتجاوز عن سيئاتهم في أصحاب الجنة وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يوعدون. In the previous verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he spoke about at-tawheed and ikhlas al-ibadati lillah, singling Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in worship, singling him in it subhanahu wa ta'ala. He also spoke about al-istiqamah, to be steadfast. And now Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, with that he connects al-wasiyyatu bil-walidain, advising us regarding our parents. Because the rights of our parents, they come right after the rights of Allah. You find the rights of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala a lot in the Qur'an. Fi ayatin iddah, fil Qur'an al-Kareem, Allah mentions the rights of the parents, and right after that, so Allah mentions his rights, and then he mentions the rights of the parents. Allah says, anishkur li waliwalidayka ilayya al-masir. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. يعني verses after verses, Allah mentions his rights and then the rights of the parents. And that shows you the station Allah has given them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ayah, وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ إِحْسَانًا, Hamza and Asim and Kisa'i, they all read it ihsanan. They read it bi ziyadati hamza, with an additional hamza, maksura qabla al-ha, which has a kasra before the ha. Okay? And a sukun on the ha, and a fatha on the sin, and a alif after them, after it. Whereas the remaining, they recited it as husnan. They placed a dhamma on it, so ihsanan, with that ziyada of the alif. Okay, ihsanan. There's a ziyada of alif, and there's the ha, يعني مكسورة قبل الحاء. The hamza has a kasra, ih. Okay, and there's a sukun on the ha, which is ih, and there's a fatha on the sin. Ihsa, and there's a alif after it. That's the recitation of Hamza and Asim and Kisa'i. Like in the other remaining qurra, they recited it with a bidhammi al-ha'i wa iskani al-sin, without the Hamza, and there's no alif. They read it as husnan. يعني أمرنا يعني it means here ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا أما حسنا. It means Allah has commanded us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, amarna, we have commanded al-insan, we have commanded the human beings, wa awjabna alayhi, and we've made it obligatory and mandatory on them, which is an yuhsina biwalidayhi ihsana, to be dutiful towards his parents, to be good towards your parents, and gentle towards them, obeying them, standing up for their rights. Allah then says, حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها عاصم and حمزة and كسائي and ابن ذكوان عن ابن عامر and يعقوب, they recited it as كرها حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها. They placed a dhamma on the calf in both places. In both places they said كرها وكرها. The other remaining قراء other than عاصم and حمزة and كساء يعني ابن ذكوان عن ابن عامر and يعقوب, they recited it as كرها in both of the places. Okay, كرها, by placing a فتحة in both places. What it means here is حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها. أما حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها, it means أي قاست أمه في حال حمله مشقة عظيمة. That your mother, she endured a lot of hardship and pain. Okay, and وتعبا شديدا, a lot of energy she exerted when she was carrying you. يعني she went through ثقل and كرب in carrying you, the different types of hardship. And then Allah says ووضعته كرها, and she gave birth to you through بمشقة عظيمة, when she was giving birth to you again. And any brother who's married, has a wife, you will see that. يعني literally you will see what your mother went through when you see your wife, how she's carrying the child 9 months. She can't sleep on one side, she's struggling, she sleeps on the other, she has to use a pillow, she has to sometimes sleep on the back, but she can't, it's so uncomfortable for her. يعني she can't sleep for maybe a continuous 1 hour or 2 hours because the baby keeps moving. A human being is growing inside her. Imagine that. Allah is mentioning this, subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's something so big and it's something so great. So when you think about it, it should touch your heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His never-ending mercy onto our parents. That is enough to know, especially our mothers, that's enough to know what they go through. Allah then says, يعني, that's not enough what your mother goes through. That's not enough. Okay? Allah then says, وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ 30 شَهْرًا. Now she has to go through the pregnancy and then the breastfeeding. 30 months of her life is taken from her. 9 months of, يعني 6 months of pregnancy, bare minimum. And the 2 years of, يعني, of breastfeeding. That breastfeeding is her nutrients. You're sucking her energy and her strength. Ya'qub, he recited it as by placing a fatha on the fa and placing a sukun on the sad without an alif. He recited it as wafasluhu. Whereas the other remaining qurra, they placed a kasra on the alif and a fatha on the sad and an alif after it. وَفِصَالُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ أما وَفَصْلُهُ both the same. It means مُدَّةُ حَمْلِهِ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ. حَمْلُهُ is what? Is the duration that the mother was carrying the child for. وَفِصَالُهُ means the breastfeeding. أي وَفِطَامُهُ. Together Allah تبارك وتعالى He says 30 شَهْرًا. Okay, How many years does she have to breastfeed the child for? She breastfeeds her child for, as Ayah mentions, وَالْوَالِدَاتُ يُرْضِعْنَ أَوْلَادَهُنَّ حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلَيْنِ لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُتِمَّ الرَّضَاعَ. 2 consecutive years. How many months is two years? 24 months. Add the 6 months of pregnancy, which is the bare minimum. The bare minimum you've taken from your mother is 6 months of pregnancy and 24 months of breastfeeding. If you're in the stomach for 9 months now, which is the majority of the times, then it becomes more than that. Then what you have now is 9 months, which you then have to add 24 months onto it. Imagine that. By the way, وَحَمْلُهُ وَفِصَالُهُ 30 شَهْرًا, the scholars, they took from this that if a woman gives birth after marriage, 6 months later, if she gives birth, that child is fine. There's nothing wrong to say that this child is not the father's son or the father's daughter. If you marry a woman and 6 months later she gives birth, you can't say you were pregnant before I got married to you. This child, someone else's. You can't. Because it could happen she gives birth at 6 months. It could happen that. The ayah mentioned that. Okay? Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he mentions, حتى إذا بلغ أشده. يعني حتى إذا بلغ أشده means when he reaches استداد, the strength of قوته البدنية, when a person reaches the physical strength, okay? And also when the person reaches the intellectual strength. As Allah mentioned subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Qasas, and he mentions in Surah Yusuf, Surah Al-Qasas, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ وَاسْتَوَى آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Like in Surah Yusuf, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. So أَشُدَّهُ here means, it means اشْتِدَادُ, when the person's physical and intellectual strength goes up. Okay? وَبَلَغَ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. 40 سنة is 40 years, and the person reaches 40 years of age. يعني 40 سنة here it means نهاية كمال القوة, is when the person's strength completes. يعني the person when they're at 40 is when they are physically and mentally strong. That's what Allah used to choose prophets then. Okay? قال, he says, ربي my Lord أوزعني, يعني وفقني ألهمني, oh Allah give me, provide for me. أن أشكر نعمتك, يعني the أن and the فعل of, يعني أن يأشكر, أشكر is a verb, right? And أن together, the scholars, they call this, it is يعني تأويل مصدر, it's the تأويل of a مصدر, يعني both of which are in في محل نصب مفعول ثان for أوزعني. يعني how do we melt a مصدر out of it? We say أوزعني شكر نعمتك, instead of saying أن أشكر, by making it into a verb and an أن before it, you can melt a مصدر out of it by saying أوزعني شكر نعمتك. Oh Allah تبارك وتعالى, give me, provide for me, ألهمني وفقني شكر نعمتك. Okay, أوزعني وفقني, give me Allah gratitude to the blessings that you've given me. If you look at the word ni'mah here, it's a mufrad, it's not a plural. And the qa'ida to the scholars is mufradun mudafun ila ma'rifatin ya'um ama fa'ya'um. If a singular is attributed, what does it show? It shows generalization. It means Rabbi my Lord alhimni waffiqni shukra jami'a ni'matika. Oh Allah, provide for me. Oh Allah, give me the ability, the strength to show gratitude for all of the blessings that you've given me. And that is by recognizing the blessing Allah has given you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one. When you say, oh Allah, give me the ability and the strength to show gratitude to all of your blessings, first of all, by recognizing it, number one. And second is by using those blessings in your obedience, Ya Rabbal Alameen. That's what it means. التي أنعمت علي, that which you have bestowed upon me. يعني من جميع النعم الدينية والدنيوية, whether it be worldly benefits or whether it be hereafter benefits, it doesn't matter. وعلى والدي, and also the ni'mah that my parents have bestowed upon me. يعني وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه. The wow here is عاطفة, and the أن and the فعل after it, يعني أن أعمل, you can again melt from it a مصدر, which is في محل نصب معطوف على المصدر السابق, which means يعني أوزعني أن أعمل, it means في المستقبل عملا صالحا خالصا لوجهك موافقا لشرعك ترضاه عني, يعني تقبله مني. وأصلح لي في ذريتي, أو الله تبارك وتعالى, يعني when the person made dua for himself, now he's going to make dua for others. And this is the tariq of the prophets. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دعا بدأ بنفسه. As the hadith mentioned, Abu Dawood narrated, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, if he supplicated, he supplicated for himself first of all. وأصلح لي في ذريتي. Now he's making dua for others now. And oh Allah, اجعل ذريتي ذرية صالحة. Oh Allah, make my progeny righteous. مخلصة لك, sincerely for you يا رب العالمين, متبعة لشرعك, and they follow your religion. Okay, they follow your religion. إني تبتُ, يعني إني تبتُ, I have repented. أي رجعتُ وأنبتُ إليك, oh Allah, I have returned back to you. I've come back running to you. وإني من المسلمين, and I am from what الذين استسلموا لك بالتوحيد. I am from those يا رب العالمين who surrendered for you in tawheed. وانقادوا لطاعتك, and I have surrendered in obeying you. I have submitted in obeying you. وأخلصوا لك من الشرك, and I have يعني purified tawheed and monotheism for you, which I do not associate partners with you. Allah then says, أُولَٰئِكَ, those who have those qualities, who are obedient towards their parents, who make these dua, who come with this, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ, these are the ones Allah is saying, نَتَقَبَّلُ عَنْهُمْ, which we accept from them, أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا, the good that they do, وَنَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, and we expiate for them their shortcomings and their faults. Hamza and Kisai and Khalaf and Hafs, they all recite it with noon that has a fatha on it. Na, na taqabbalu, na taqabbalu. There's a fatha on that noon. Na tajawazu. That's how they recite it. Ahsana. All of those, they recite it like that. Like in the other remaining qurra, they recited it as what? They place a dhamma on it. Yutaqabbalu. يتجاوزوا أحسنوا, يعني أحسنوا بالرفع. Before it was أحسن. نتجاوزوا نتقبلوا. Okay, يعني what it means, أولئك الذين نتقبلوا, here means أولئك الموصوفون, those who have this description which was mentioned, meaning they repent to Allah. إني تبت إليك, those who repent to Allah تبارك وتعالى, those who surrendered to Allah تبارك وتعالى التوحيد, وانقادوا له بالطاعة, وأخلصوا له, and they are sincerely for him سبحانه وتعالى, and they don't يعني associate partners with him. نتقبل عنهم أحسن ما عملوا. The ma is موصولة according to one إعراب. You can say it's a verbal noun. If you want to, you can actually say it's a مزدرية, يعني it's a موصولة connective, or you can say it's a مزدرية verbal noun. You have those two choices. If you say it is a mawsoola, a connective, it means أَحْسَنَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوهُ, the good which they did. That's what the ma here is. أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوهُ here means أَحْسَنَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوهُ. That's when it's a mawsoola. But if it's a verbal noun, it means أَحْسَنَ عَمَلَهُمْ. أَحْسَنَ عَمَلَهُمْ أي جميع الطاعات, the good, all of the good deeds that they did. وَنَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ means, نَتَجَاوَز here means أي نَعْفُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ. فَنَغْفِرُ لَهُمْ الزَّلَلْ, Allah forgives you for your shortcomings, your little mistakes that you do, and Allah تبارك وتعالى, he accepts the little that you do. وَنَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ. فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَنَّةِ here means أي في جملة أصحاب الجنة, they are from the people and the dwellers of Jannah, they are the أهل of Jannah, they are the سكان of Jannah, the inhabitants of Jannah. وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يعدون. The word وعد here is a مفعول مطلق. So the مفعول المطلق generally comes from a verb that was before it. So where is the verb that was before it? The verb here is محذوف. It's hidden. Okay, and it's a يعني it's لفعل محذوف. It's for a verb which is محذوف مؤكد, which is emphasized لمضمون الجملة السابقة. So in other words, it's what وعد الصدق والحق الثابت الذي كانوا يوعدون به من ربهم, أي الذي لا يخلف الميعاد. Allah does not break his promise سبحانه وتعالى. Anything he says سبحانه وتعالى, anything he informs us of is the truth, nothing but the truth سبحانه وتعالى. As Allah said in another ayah, when he spoke about himself, he said سبحانه وتعالى ولا ينبئك مثل خبير. There's no one who can inform you about things the way Allah can. What he tells you, وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا, أي صِدْقًا فِي الْأَخْبَارِ وَعَدْلًا فِي الْأَحْكَامِ. Whatever he says is true, whatever he informed us of is true subhanahu wa ta'ala, and every judgment of his subhanahu wa ta'ala is nothing but fairness. وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يوعدون. This is a promise Allah has made subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who came with those qualities. May Allah make us all from those people. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdi ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.